Coalition for Environmental Solidarity. Mouthful. Spaces is dedicated to being a place for philanthropic activism while we explore the issues of the U.S. impact environmentally on the Philippines. Spaces was founded in 2000 where we worked on the former bases of Subic and Clark with the communities who have been greatly impacted by the toxic waste left over from the U.S. military. We currently work with those communities as well as a community called Pandacan, which is in Metro Manila. It is a community of 84,000 residents that live directly fence-lined to an oil depot owned jointly by Shell, Petron, and Chevron. Chevron, who has its headquarters here in San Ramon, California. We work with these communities for environmental justice and explore kind of the overlap between what it means that the U.S. was in the Philippines for so long and still has remnants and fingertips in the ties in the Philippines. Why would Faith respond to this as an environmental organization? I think I said earlier, FACES is very much tied to this idea of being a place for young Filipinos to explore what it means to feel very tied to our homeland, even if we were born here. And also a space for people who are interested in these ideas of U.S. kind of the post-imperialist, if I can say that, post-imperialist impacts of having been in the Philippines. We think transnational environmental justice is still very much a current issue, and that we can't discuss a lot of issues in the Philippines and justice in the Philippines without talking about U.S. responsibility and culpability. And then, of course, Ben Pimentel, who is the author of the book, highlighted today has been an amazing ally to FACES, and we thank him for his wisdom that he's given us. If you enjoyed today's event, FACES is also holding a national conference early February, February 6th and 8th, as well as an exhibit on one of the communities we work with called Pandacan, A Legacy of Pride and Pollution. It's where you can learn about a community that's very downtrodden and heavily impacted by a U.S.-based company. So feel free to pick up that information in the back. Again, thanks to the Philippine American Center here at the Library and the Manilatown Heritage Foundation. We are so grateful to be able to hold this event with you. And then I'd like to introduce Francis Calpatura, who will be introducing Ben for like a chance. So Francis came to the United States in 1977, having gone to the same school in the Philippines as Ben Pimentel. Since 1984, he has worked as a community organizer, working with Asian, Latino, and African-American communities all over the country. Francis has also written about social movements in Color Lines magazine, Alternet, and Social Policy. He helped start numerous initiatives, including the Asian Pacific Environmental Network, the National Organizers Alliance, and the Alliance for Philippine Concerns. A few years ago, he founded the Transnational Institute for Grassroots Research and Action, TIGRA, to turn immigrant dollars into a force to hold the global financial services industry accountable to the communities that they benefit from. Frank is also a former board member of FACES, and his wisdom and activism has been invaluable, not just to FACES, but for Philam activism in general. He will do a little reflection about the book as a way of introducing Ben Pimentel. Welcome, Francis Calvert. Sorry, one more note before Fran and Ben show on. Can you please put your cell phones on vibrate or turn them off? Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you very much for that introduction and synthesis. Magandang tanghali po sa inyong lahat. Good afternoon to everybody. Kamusta kayo? How are you?
Good.
I know you're really here to hear Ben talk about his book, but indulge me for a couple of minutes as I reflect on what I think Ben is urging us and challenging us to do as people in the Filipino-American community here in the United States, as we move into this era of the Barack Obama administration. We all have a story to tell of where we were on November 4th when the networks announced Barack Obama as the 44th president of the United States. It was a glorious evening. And in Ben's book, it chronicles kind of where we were, in fact, during that evening. We were at Marriott with about 1,000 other people in downtown Oakland celebrating the announcement of Barack Obama's victory. But I want to reflect on a couple of things. First is personal, and the other is going to be more about our community here in the United States and the community that we left behind in the Philippines. First of all, for me personally, Barack Obama signifies a personal marker, a personal high mark, whose success I can relate to in my own personal life. I am able to see myself in him as a community organizer. He worked for many years in the South Side of Chicago, doing the very exact same work that a lot of us here have tried to do to improve the conditions in our communities. He worked in the African American community in the South Side of Chicago, trying to develop programs so that young kids, young adults, would have an option for jobs rather than a life of misery. I could also relate to Barack Obama personally because he comes from a global experience, again, much like a lot of us here. His was with Indonesia and Kenya, mine, the United States and the Philippines. Finally, I see in him the joy and the pride of many poor African Americans in neighborhoods across the country that I've organized in, who have been consigned to another generation of poverty. Obama indeed represents a new destination in their long journey that I hope we also celebrate. Therefore, kind of Barack Obama signifies a high water mark again in my own experience as a Filipino here in America. And all of us, and I hope that in a little while, we will all tell our own stories about that as well, the significance for each one of us of the election of Barack Obama. However, I think Boying's book, or Ben Pimentel's book, challenges to consider or even embrace Obama's ascendancy as a historical landmark for our own community, of the Filipino journey towards justice in America and even in our homeland, since, as Christine said, America figures prominently in our own historical context. The ascent of a black man in America, if we are, forces us, I think, if we are bold enough to allow it, to reconstruct our collective historical consciousness about race and religion, correcting a destructive storyline, I think, that's been chiseled in our psyche, that made us fear blackness, exalt whiteness, and make us uncomfortable in our own brown skin. Complicate race with religion, and you can see the historical storyline includes fear of Muslims as the other whose communities deserve to be bombed and strafed by militaries, domestic and foreign, in the Philippines. It is an ideology of violence and exclusion that pits brothers against sisters, crafted for us to fight each other, and prevents us in summoning our better angels. Ben Pimentel, I think, challenges us to consider the election of Barack Obama an historical marker to reconstruct a new historical storyline for Filipinos, finding ourselves in a multicultural and globalized world. The hint on where we can start this reconstruction is with the title of the book, Pareng Barack. I, familiar, not distant, family and friend, not a stranger. If we begin by embracing the significance of the Obama election as part of our own historical march for justice, then we've made it a historical marker for all of us. And this little book would have made that possible. Now let me introduce the person and the family, in fact, that